बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, वेलकम टू द क्लास। दिस इज द कोर्स प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स। आई एम डॉक्टर ईशान कलीम फ्रॉम एसी डिपार्टमेंट, सीयूआई वॉक कैंपस। द कोर्स टाइटल इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स एंड दिस इज 3+1, इट मीन्स 4 आवर कोर्स। देर विल बी अ 3 क्रेडिट आवर्स फॉर अ coursework and there will be a 1 credit hour for a lab. I am Dishan Kaleem and my location is EC Faculty Hall, Alam Iqbal Block, CUI Wah Campus, and you can contact me on the following email address as well. And this is my web page. And objective of this course is to teach you the general components in communication system, and we will review time and frequency domain analysis of signals and systems, and we will run amplitude modulation, digital modulation that includes pulse code modulation, etc. Okay, let's move towards the grading policy in this course. There will be assignments and quizzes which will have a weightage of 25%, and there will be a sectional 1 exam that has a 10% weightage, and sectional 2 exam is 15% weightage. And finally, we have a final exam which will have a 50% weightage. The big book which we will follow as a textbook here in this course is the Modern Digital and Analog Communication System by B.P. Lathi. And the book you can see from here. And the other reference book can be signed from written by an author, Simon Hyken, Communication Systems, and so on. And we will assume you have a background of signals and systems and basic digital communication system as well. So these are the course details. As I mentioned, principles of communication system, the course code is 3351, and the prereq is signals and system, and the book is Analog and Digital Communication System by V.P. Lathi, and other reference books are mentioned here. And this is a 3 credit hour per week for a theory and 1 lab session per week. Okay, let's discuss the course outline and the CLOs and PLOs coverage. Firstly, we will cover introduction. The chapter title will be the introduction, and that will cover the CLO 1 and will map to the PLO 1, means the program learning outcome 1. And the next chapter will be signals and system, signals and signal space, and that will also cover, will be under the coverage of CLO1 and the map to the PLO1. And third chapter will be analysis and transmissions of signals, that will be from CLO1 and map to PLO1 as well. Fourth chapter will be amplitude modulations and demodulations, that is the CLO2 and map to the PLO2 as well. And the fifth chapter will be angle modulation and demodulation, map to CLO1 and map to the CLO2, belongs to CLO2 and map to PLO2. Sixth chapter is sampling and analog digital to conversion, CLO3 and map to PLO1. The final chapter will be principles of digital data transmission, CLO3 and map to PLO1. Let's discuss what these CLO 1, 2, and 3 are. So CLO 1, we will comprehend the basic concepts of communication systems, signal transmission, representation, and apply these concepts in the analysis of communication system. So this is CLO 1, which belongs to theory. And CLO2, which is mapped to PLO2, demonstrate the principles of analog modulations and demodulation, analyze and evaluate their performance. This is also from theory, right? And describe the fundamental concept of digital communication systems. This is CLO3 and mapped to PLO1. And CLO4 will be excel in implementing the learned concepts on communication lab equipments and modern IT tools. This is the CLO4, and it belongs to lab. So there will be one CLO for a lab, and the rest of 3 CLOs belongs to theory. So this would be covered in the lab. And these all are map to the PLOs. So PLO1 is engineering knowledge, and PLO2 is problem analysis, and PLO5, which will be modern tool usage. So these are the PLOs. You can see the detailed description if you like. So lecture contents: in this lecture we will cover introduction to communication system, frequency allocation. Okay, let's move to the detailed lecture contents. First of all, what is components of communication system? So if you see that this is the basic block of a communication system. First of all, we need to, as you know, that in communication we need to transmit a message from input to the output. So this is input message and this is your output message. But to transmit this message from one place to another, we need these kinds of processing blocks, right? These are the processing blocks, major processing blocks. So what are these? Input message, first it will pass to input transducer. When it would be required, if you need to change the one source of energy into another source of energy. For example, your source originates a message. It could be a human voice, television, picture or data. Then source is converted by input transducer to an electrical waveform, referred to as the baseband signal or a macro signal. If you have a message like human voice, television, picture or a data, that would be an input message. And if you like to convert into an electrical waveform, as mentioned here, which is named as a baseband signal or a message signal, then you will pass it to the transducer. So finally you will get the electrical waveform, and then you will pass it to the transmitter. Transmitter has number of blocks. We will see these blocks later on. But transmitter, it will pass to the transmitter, and this, it will transmit the message into the air or the wireless medium. This is called a transmitted signal, and that medium is called a channel. So after passing to the channel, we will receive the receive signal. But when the signal passes through the channel, it will introduce distortion and noise, because channel is a medium, and in wireless medium there will be a distortion as well as a noise from the receiver side. So what is the process, which are the detailed description of transmitter? It modifies the baseband signal for efficient transmission. The transmitter then generally consists of one or more of the following subsystems, like sampler, quantizer, coder or a modulator. These are the blocks that are included on the transmitter side. So it can be sampler, quantizer, coder, modulator. And for a channel, I mentioned that there will be distortion and noise, and on the receiver there will be a reverse operation as performed here on the transmitter side. To convert back to the baseband signal, it will pass to the receiver and it will reverse. It will have a block that will convert back to the original message. So this will be output signal, and then output transducer to convert the electrical signal back to the message. Right, so this is the major block diagram of the communication system. So little more description about the channel. As I mentioned, is a medium through which the transmitter output is sent, which could be a wire, coaxial cable, optical fiber or a radio link, which I mentioned as a wireless link here. So modern communication channels are divided into two categories: wireline channel and wireless channels. So receiver reproduces the signal received from the channel by undoing the signal modification made at the transmitter and the channel. So the purpose of receiver is to just undo the same signal which was transmitted from the transmitter side by doing some modification. So it will undo that modification and recover the original signal. So receiver may consist of a demodulator, decoder, filter and a de-emphasizer. The receiver output is fed to the output transducer, which converts the electrical signal to its original form. So this is the purpose of the transducer. So these are some descriptions of the basic building block of communication system. This is a detailed block of the communication system, which is important to understand if you are an engineer or a communication engineer. So you must have a knowledge how the transmitter works and how the receiver works. So I will give an overview of this communication system block diagram here. For example, as I mentioned that the original message is called the baseband message. Original message means the message with that you speak, and for example, I am speaking, this message generated is a baseband. It means it has a low frequency, usually it has a low frequency, and there will be a no, without modification, this is called a baseband signal. So this part is called a baseband. When it passes to the there are some processing and there are modulation, so it is moved to higher frequency. So these higher frequencies are called passband. So these higher frequency operations are performed here. So this is the passband block, and this is the channel, and these are the receiver side. So there will be an undoing process over here. So transmitter and the receiver. Let's move on. For example, if you already have a digital data, then you need to start from here, from the channel coding, right? And if you don't have a digital data, if you have analog data like here, so first you will pass it to the anti-aliasing filter. This is a source coding block, right? So anti-aliasing, we will not go into much detail, but simple is that what it will do. Aliasing means there will be a overlap between the two signals, for example. So anti-aliasing filter will try to remove that overlap, and there will be a proper frequency gap between the two signals, so that the signal, there will be no interference among the signal. So this process, so first of all we will pass the audio signal to the anti-aliasing filter, so it will cut the higher frequencies, so in this way unnecessary higher frequencies, and there will be no aliasing in this. So after passing the audio signal from here, we will pass to the analog to digital converter. So this is to convert analog signal into digital form. So there will be a steps like micro sampling, etc. This part will be covered in the last chapter of this course. So then it will pass to the channel coding block. What is channel coding block? Actually, channel coding means, as you know, that when the signal passes through any medium, there will be some distortion, as I mentioned before. So to overcome that distortion, we send some security bits. That security bits are called the channel coding bits, because these security bits introduce the security. So these bits are called the channel code. So there are different types of channel coding, which is not a part of this course. So you can study later on in different course as well. Then it will pass to the pulse shaping filter. So pulse shaping filter will remove the inter-symbol interference. What is inter-symbol interference? Inter-symbol interference means that when there is a, when you transmit the data from transmitter to the receiver, there can be multiple copies. So to avoid overlapping these multiple copies, we need to avoid pulse shaping filter, simply. So that will avoid interfering the different symbols. So pulse shaping filter has a purpose to avoid that interference. Modulation means that when you need to switch this to the higher frequency to for transmission. So there can be a digital or analog modulation schemes. So modulation we will cover later on in this course. Then there will be a channel filter. The purpose of channel filter is to move to cut the unnecessary band and to transmit the signal within the specified pass band, right? Then it will pass through the communication channel. The communication channel will introduce loss, interference, noise, distortion, etc. And after passing, it will again, there will be a reverse process like channel filter again, demodulation, regeneration, channel decoding, and digital. If it was a digital signal, so digital to analog conversion, low pass filter. So these are, this was the some introduction of the communication system. So in summary, what is the purpose of source encoding decoding? Source encoding will reduce the redundancy of the data, and the encryption and decryption. Encryption will improve the security and privacy. Channel encoding and decoding. Channel encoding will help to avoid interferences, and the modulation and demodulation, it will be helpful in channel adaptation and sharing. So these are the some key blocks in the communication system, and with their summary, working summary. So this is the frequency allocation of communication system, and there is a band from 300 hertz, starting from 300 hertz and moving to a terahertz. So twisted pair cable usually work in the range of 300 hertz. VL means very low frequency, LF means low frequency, medium frequency, high frequency, VHF very high frequency, so on up to visible light, right? So the coaxial cable range is starting from very low frequency and lying in the ultra high frequency, 300 megahertz up to 300 megahertz. From here we have a super high frequency, infrared, so on. So usually we have a communication, nowadays we have a communication within this range, 30 kilohertz to up to some gigahertz, right? 2 gigahertz, 3 gigahertz. But in future, in like in 5G, 6G, they are moving towards high frequency band, like from 30 gigahertz to terahertz, this block. So they are nowadays testing the system and their performances. But the problem here would be a loss in the signal. As we have a very high frequency, there will be more loss, right? So this can be a problem in when we move toward the high frequency band. So usually they are following the low frequency band, and the advantage of low frequency is the high range. Usually they provide high range. It means that the signal can travel very far. The distance of the traveling is very far. So these are some frequency allocation in the communication system. So here we will finish our first lecture, and thank you for listening. And for question answer, there will be a separate session, online session. The exact date and time will be communicated later on. Thank you.